In today's video, we are going to be learning how to automate images. We're going to dive into some generative AI tools and technologies that help automate a lot of different tasks. In this specific video, we are going to be looking at my favorite currently image generating tool and image editing tool, which is Adobe Firefly. The best part that is currently in beta and is absolutely free. You can create as many amazing and professional images as you want. So I do invite you to sign up and join right now because it is currently, again, free and it's really fun to use. Now, compared to DALL-E and also compared to Stable Diffusion, in my opinion, it produces much better results. When we compare it to MindJourney produces great results. However, it has really long and complicated prompts that you need to master in order to create great images. Now, if you are not able to create great prompts, you will not have consistency in your images. Now, this is another reason why I like Adobe Firefly, because it gives you the flexibility to control your prompts. Let's dive into it and see how this is done. We're going to start with the most basic tool, and that is the part where we are going to transform text into images. Now, once we click on it, we can click in the bar right here and write our prompt, or we can take inspiration, which I really like, from all of the different prompts right here. Now, also keep in mind, this is very important. Adobe Firefly has been trained on the stock images from Adobe. Therefore, all of these images are open source and are not breaking any copyright law. This is not the same for DALL-E, Stable Diffusion, and MindJourney, who have been trained also on copyrighted images. Now, let's try this tool and see what we can get out of it. Let's input a prompt here that is going to be feet resting on computer keyboard. And for good practice, we're going to take this prompt. We're going to put it into DALL-E as well. And we are going to put it into Stable Diffusion. So this is DALL-E, and let's put it into Stable Diffusion. We have seen that Stable Diffusion has actually updated the software. This is actually from yesterday to today. Now you can also enter a negative prompt to help you control a little bit more the images. Now in image generation, controlling images is very important because you want to get a consistent effect and you also want to get what you really want. Now this is what we got. We got some feet on a keyboard. They look like they're typing. Not really what I wanted in neither one of these examples. So let's try to be a little bit more specific with this. I don't want an art, I would like to have a graphic. I would also like to change it and maybe make it something more, a little bit steampunk. And let's also add a couple of different colors. So let's add vibrant color, lighting, let's add some studio lighting and the composition. Let's also add a wide angle. Now I have added a lot of different parameters that otherwise I would have had to have coded and known and inserted also by myself. I'm also going to add one more parameter, which is going to be cyberpunk, and let's see what kind of image it generates. Now, I can also change the image, so let's change this into a more of a widescreen image. And all of this without having to know different prompts. Now, the results are pretty good, in my opinion, without having to spend too much time on working on this. So this is something actually that I like. So I could take this picture and submit it to the gallery, meaning that I can share it with everybody else, or I can use it as a reference picture. What does that mean? Now let's use this as a reference picture and generate three more examples of something similar to that picture. Now we have something similar in MindJourney as well. However, it is inside of a Discord chat and it is relatively more complex to use. As I said previously, you have to know how to use different prompts and be very specific with your prompts if you want good results. Now, let's go back into this, into our process. So this is an image that I actually particularly like. Now, I could do different things. I could use generative fill or remove different parts of the image. Now, we can also show similar images as well and just generate three more images that looks similar to this. However, they are not a reference image, but they are similar. Again, I do invite you to check out all of the different images and different options that you have here to change and play around. Remember, this is entirely for free right now, so you can play with it as much as you like. Once you find an image that you like, you can download it onto your computer. So let's see our image that has been downloaded. And this is the image that has been downloaded on our computer. Now, as you can see, Adobe has added this sign right here that says that this image is under that has been generated by AI. Now, the newest regulations on AI in the European Union dictate that every company that is generating content with AI has to declare in some way that that content has been generated by AI. Therefore, they are not only using not copyrighted images, but they're also adhering to the newest laws and regulations. This is a great tool that has also been integrated inside of Photoshop and other Adobe applications. Now, let me show you the other part, which is generative fill. Now, once we click on generative fill, we can change different parts of this image. So, for example, I can remove a part of this image and I can add a cable or I can add some wires. So once I click generate, it is going to try to generate different options for me to insert inside of this image. So as you can see, it has generated a wire and it fits perfectly well inside of my image. And this part wasn't here before. Now I can keep this image. I can do different things to this. So for example, I can change different settings of the brush that I'm using. This is best seen if we upload a new image. Now let's upload a new image of myself. And we are going to change this to something a little bit more fun. The first thing we're going to do is remove the background of this image. And with just one click, this tool entirely for free is going to do a professional job of removing the image. The next thing, we're going to use the brush in the settings and we're going to reduce the brush size a little bit to 12 and just try to keep my head so that we can create a professional looking headshot. Let's increase the brush size and remove the rest of this image. So like this, I just have my face and then I'm going to write professional headshot with a business setting. Now I can further fine tune this and have it preserve the original content or have it a new content, or I can have it more towards the prompt or to the original content. Now, the more I move towards the prompt, the more crazy and the more imaginative the image is going. Now let's generate and see what is going to happen with this image. Now, let me remind you that if I didn't have this tool, I would have had to use Photoshop or other applications that would have required me to have pretty good skills in editing images and also have to pay different licenses for different tools to use. Now, let me remind you again, this tool is completely for free and this image, I can already say that I'm pretty satisfied with the lighting of this image and also with the proportions, and nothing looks quite distorted. This image is also pretty nice, as well as is this one and this one as well. Now, all of the images look good. Now, I can also, for example, this image that I like right here, I can keep this image and then I can further play around with this image. So, for example, I can again remove the background if I don't like it and add a cyberpunk city. And let's see what would happen with when we say cyberpunk city. Now, right now I am combining two different AI generated images into one in just a couple of minutes. This is really powerful, especially because the limit is your imagination and the quality is very high. Therefore, you can produce very good results. And as you can see, I have changed the background, combining two different images and only having my face as the real part of this image. I could also add all kinds of different backgrounds or effects, change the color of the tie, of the shirt, and so on. This is amazing. And what is also even more amazing is that there is more tools for you to discover. Text effects, where you can generate amazing text with just a few prompts, such as like pizza, and you could write the text that you want, such as, for example, RPA champion. So here we have the RPA champion in a pizza composition. So that is also pretty cool. And I can also download this in just one click. There is a lot more tools for you to discover, such as changing the color of an image to something that is more in your style or within your presentation, or generating 3D images, which is currently in beta and in exploration, and you can play around with it and check it out because it's for free and it also provides some really good starting points for you to save a lot of time. Remember, ladies and gentlemen, on this channel, we are all about saving time with automation. And one of the best ways of automation is artificial intelligence because it automates cognitive and reasoning tasks. Now, when we combine this with RPA or robotic process automation that automates manual and repetitive tasks, we are going to achieve end-to-end automation and we're not going to have to touch a computer ever again for our business processes. So, ladies and gentlemen, if you have enjoyed this video, I advise you to check out my course on generative AI and the link is down in the description below. Thank you so much for watching and I will see you in the next video.